Our referee for tonight is Mr. Matt Randall. Our opening contest is for the Cash In Challenge.
Today, here at Visiting Time from the Asylum,
your winner via referee's decision and forfeit and qualified for the Catch In Challenge, the Super Dad.
Well, can you believe it? The greatest matches we've ever seen on Visiting Time at the Asylum has just finished. Super Dad, your winner.
As long as that bloke in the crowd doesn't show them his card, we'll be alright. Now that's out of the way, let's move on to our second contest and hope somebody's turned up.
Is wild today, but they might just be rabid.
No matter how hard you try, you can't stop us now.
Why, who's that?
Oh, yeah. It's Richard Lewis.
You heard him, it's Richard Lewis. And there is his partner in crime, the Bomb Stamp House, with Sophie. Can you believe it? Richard Delight is looking for double duty on the 14th of April. As he defends his tag team championships with the Bomb Stamp Powers against TOD, the Toothpick of Doom, and Mr. Silent E himself, Sam Irvin. Crowd not responding to them delightfully.
And they deserve it!
You heard it here first, they don't deserve it.
Ladies and gentlemen, introducing first, accompanied today by his tag team partner and Sophie Broom.
She's over there.
There she is. She's got that lovely.
And BCW tag team champions.
BCW tag team champions.
Richie
Delight!
Jimmy Delight! No, 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 no.
verbal joust has begun between them and the crowd. But the physical joust should happen eventually as well. Probably when the bell rings and they have a match. Of the wrestling variety! And here is long-term rival to the delightful powers of Richard Light, Joel Lightning, one half of the former tag team champions in a BECW. Joel Lightning. I would like to point out that 50% of this match is in kick pads.
And his opponent is one half of the former BECW tag team champions.
Former
champion.
We're going to see some action in this match compared to the last match, which had no action whatsoever, but it had an outcome. An outcome with a winner. Good afternoon, Grapple fans. It's me, James Earls, your BCW champion. Here, the voice, back again with It's... Oh, my voice will come.
Oh, I love
that.
You remember me?
I remember you.
I'm that guy who did commentary.
You weren't here last week.
I know, aren't I lucky?
Oh, man, I get stuck with Ben Lawrence.
I know.
So here we go. The bell has sounded. We're back in HD.
HD?
HD, high definition.
That doesn't sound for heavy duty, does it? Because that'd be rubbish.
Here we are with our opening contest.
It's the second contest. Did you not see that first one? It was an epic!
I was there. It wasn't a...
Biblical proportions! As Richard Delight working on the arm of Joel Lightning.
He is. Of course, no strangers to each other.
I know.
Oh, the pull of the hair.
Well, it's good wrestling. The referee's not reprimanding him for it, is he?
And there he is, Stamp Powers, his tag team partner. Tag. Oh, he throws him down again.
Of course, alongside Sophie T. Broom.
Sophie Broom.
Is it Sophie T. Broom?
Oh, and Joe Lightning goes to the back again.
He's after the wrist lock. And he's, you notice here, Richard Lloyd has an elbow pad
yes.
on his left arm. Maybe there's something wrong there, because the other arm is fine.
Yes. Not wearing these. Traditionally, you would wear two elbow pads.
Two elbow pads or no elbow pads at all.
There we are. Richie Delight getting a nice bit of pep talk there from his tag team partner, Stan Towers.
Richie Delight looking for double duty.
Yes. He wants to win that catch
challenge.
At least
event, which is on Sunday, which is...
Highway to Hell.
Yeah, all right, now.
Highway to Hell coming next Sunday, April 14th, from the BCW Asylum. Tickets on the door.
Okay.
Of course, the main event for that card. Joel Lightning's tag team partner, Leo Shadows.
Leo Shadows?
Who won the Absolute World for the number one contendership to face me, the champion, James Earls.
Look at this action we're seeing here. Full Nelson applied by Joel Lightning.
And of course, Joel Lightning in traditional wrestling vest.
Wrestling vest indeed.
And kick pad.
I've already mentioned that.
All right.
50% this match in kick pads. In KP. But we're not talking nuts and we're not talking McCoys.
No,
we're talking kick pad.
Oh, head there, takedown.
There's a lean to the back, creating an extra bit of pressure on the shoulder blades.
Yes. The referee for today, Matt Randall. And Richard Delight spills out to the outside.
He doesn't want to spill things, he might slip.
Get some help there.
Oh, and the slosher getting involved.
They are. There's a few of them, I've seen them.
Kids in the day, eh?
And there we go. Richard Delight contemplating when they get back in the ring.
It does come after one.
Two.
I know. It means you weren't educated in Ellis
School. That's why I went to school in Wimbledon.
Wimbledon?
I went to Wimbledon College.
School in College. I went to the renowned Riddlesdown High School.
Riddlesdown, were you?
My brother was in the same year as Nigel Rear Coker.
Do, Nigel Rear Coker. Oh, the pin, one, two! Oh.
pulled anything this match, really, have we?
Yes, we have. There was a couple of moves.
There we have. There's another one. The referee getting in there. The crowd are a little bit of electricity in the air.
Well, maybe we should unplug them.
Possibly. Bridge to the light now. Whips them in the corner. Oh, shoulder charge to the gut. Having technical difficulties with our HD camera today.
HD. That means we can watch it on a massive telly, which is unnecessary. When it's a real telly, it's more to say.
Look at that armbar.
That's one of these 1001 holes.
1001.
Doesn't know four, does he?
No. A leg takedown.
Oh. He's trying to get his legs. He's turning around.
Stan Powers there pushing the rope in back to a headlock.
Joel Lightning forced to change his what's the word called again? You know, where you plan for something but then you don't.
Strategy!
There we are.
Something like that, yeah.
Strategy. I like being champion, it's nice. Yeah.
Me Grimlock say he needs a strategy.
Oh, poor Grimlock. King King! Grimlock King!
Me Grimlock say we on our way! Hopefully to the next match. Armbar reapplied by Richie Delight.
Oh, a stroke to the shoulder. And Richie Delight there offering a slosh to get into the ring.
He is!
And she's up!
Oh! And he cut her off!
He cut her off. Oh, and look at that. Look at
he
that.
Took her down that awful ground.
And the referee there administering
the Stan Powers pose.
He gets the powers!
And the slosh there, you dumb red. One, two.
Oh, only a two. Just barely getting your shoulder off the canvas.
Yeah, Stan Powers there just stretching off the ropes. All right, Stan.
Oh, atomic drop!
Should have thrown a grenade.
That
circle.
It's a popular move in Brighton as the atomic drop.
Yes. In some parts of Manchester.
In some parts.
Yeah. According to Channel 4 at least.
Well, they put the man in Manchester.
Joe Lightning there. Reverse.
Oh!
Yes. That's a forearm.
Oh, really?
That's a punch. It turns into a forearm.
There's not much pepper left in those pump.
And Richard Delight spills out.
He dropped him like it's hot.
And there is Sam Powers consoling his tag team partner. The referee.
What kind of console is it? Is it a Nintendo or a PlayStation?
Oh, maybe an Xbox. Joe Lightning there.
Oh! Splat-tacular!
Oh, that sounded like that hurt. That sounded like that really did hurt.
Of course it hurts. It's wrestling.
That was a horrible thud. Richard Delight there just cleaned out
Stan Powers. There was a DP potty on the floor there.
And he's still having some crossface.
What is he doing?
And Stan Powers getting moved.
Oh! Ref!
That's a disqualification.
Surely that's a disqualification. He just said, rip him out. Rip him out.
He's disqualified him.
Oh my God, it's over. Why can't we have a clean finish? Just once!
Who booked it? Oh! Falcon Arrow!
Not as bad as wasn't on one side of the room, but it was hard for it. It was the Holocaust.
Apparently this is how you wrestle. Vertical suplex.
It's just doing a suplex. It's not really how you wrestle. That's just how you do a move.
Oh! Suplex, shakes Arrow. The British Bulldog. Or any other wrestler that likes to do a stolen suplex.
Where's Leo Shadows in this?
Where is Leo Shadows?
Why won't he save his partner? Obviously he's gone into business for himself to challenge you.
Yes. And went into the corner. Why is the referee letting his... Oh!
Up and at them! Up and at them! Up and at them!
Oh! Well, the main thing to come out of this is Joe Lightning was qualified for the cash-in challenge.
Isn't he a lucky boy?
Isn't he just?
He doesn't look like a winner. He looks like a wiener.
Well, we haven't had an official word. DP's entrance music is playing.
Oh, no. That makes no sense whatsoever. or he does. They are.
Of the contest,
that music sounds very ghetto. And they're pointing people out. Look at Sophie go. That's exactly what you want to see from a woman sweeping away. That's why that broom's called Sophie. But I'd like to tell you that the comments I've just expressed are those of Ben Lawrence, your head conspirator, and not those of the commentary team. As Joel Lightning hobbles backstage after being victorious. We'll see him in the cash-in challenge.
Your winner, Joel Lightning.
All those other guys are in it. Who will cash in? I don't know, but we're going to find out eventually. You know, that's how it happens.
Now time for our third contest of the afternoon. This is a cash-in challenge qualifier match for Highway to Hell.
I get the hint that a lot of these are going to be qualifiers. Somebody's going to enter the ring. Who could it be? Look who it is! The Platinum Standard! The pride of Platinum Standard! Damien, and the man in this particular contest, Mr. Aaron Smith! It is his fault!
Introducing first, accompanied to the ring by his tag team partner, Damien Ryan!
Damien Ryan there.
He is the standout star and a member of the Platinum Standard, Aaron Smith!
That is the team pride of the Platinum Standard. Smith and Ryan. He has got this. You just told me, I know. Yes, you've said this. Why are you talking to me? Talk to him. Stop making me change the camera angle. Hang on a minute, what's going on? Have the Platinum Standard already got to Aidan Gallagher? Aidan Gallagher doesn't seem to know where he is. Is this a conspiracy by Ben Lawrence? Let's find out. Continue, even start this match. Why are we allowing this? What? What? No! Oh my God! It's over! Oh my God! Woods.
Again, Ben. This is your fault. This is your fault, Ben.
Oh, God.
That's on you. You won the match. He won it the match. You got the match. You beat you. And now I've got knocked out 2 weeks in a row. Why can't you take 2 weeks in a row?
He beat you.
There are some serious medical implications here. He has been knocked out 2 weeks in a row. What? Where's... If only Tiger Lock was here to help out Aidan Gallagher. These winners actually look like a winner for once. Can you believe this? It looks like he's come to a bit. Looks like Ben Lawrence is going to help him backstage. But he should have helped him while he was taking the beating, really, shouldn't he? Is it a conspiracy that Ben Lawrence did not help his employee from stop his employee from getting knocked out 2 weeks in a row? There are serious health issues involved here. Professional boxers can't even train 2 weeks after being punched, knocked out cold.